Okay, we're going to manually program this tool path to go in and just cut around the perimeter of this bottle opener that we're going to use. So this is just a little animation from NX. Eventually, maybe the next assignment, you'll go in and actually program this using NX. But today we're still doing manual programming, just trying to get you an idea of what we're going to do. We're going to come in, move the tool down, go around the perimeter. You see that we've got lead ins and lead outs. Those nice little arc moves as it goes in. It engages the material along an arc instead of just plowing straight into it. So we'll program those in. Of course, we'll have to do our cutter compensation for this as well. All right, so this is a drawing that is similar to but not the same as the drawing that you'll have on the website for your assignment. So make sure that you use the numbers, the dimensions that are on your assignment and not this one. So this will be slightly different from the one that you're going to be doing. All right, so also the if you'll read on the assignment, it's going to tell you that the origin, that your part zero origin is going to be dead center in the middle of this part, and I'll show you on the fixture in just a few minutes where that is, but it's going to be dead center vertically and horizontally of this part. Okay, so make sure if you go to all the trouble to plot your coordinates that you put the origin in the right spot. It is, in this case, not negotiable, so it has to be in that very center. Okay, so the assignment will tell you to adjust the header. I'm going to adjust it, but I don't remember what were the actual tool offsets, tool number and tool offset, and the part zero origin. So make sure that you use the, I think it's G59, but double check that. Get those, get the tool number, get that information off of the assignment. All right, make sure that you update those. Then this is a file. This is that same header. And I've already got something started in here, but it's not for this exercise. So I'm going to clear that out. Also, be advised, we are not ever going to take the tool to Z0. We're not going to take it to anything less than Z.625. So let's go ahead and program that and get that out of the way. So first off, we'll do a rapid until we get above our starting point. Now, we have two different choices of starting points. Notice this, that if we start here, we'll go in and we'll move around the part in this direction and then come out. And we have the option, though, of coming in this direction and moving around the part in the opposite direction. Are they equivalent? Well, the answer is no, they're not. So one is going to be climb milling and one is going to be conventional milling. So what we want to do is climb mill. Our cutter is going to be turning clockwise, and that means that if we come in this direction, we will be climb milling, and that is what we want to do. We could have a whole discussion on that, but we've already done that. So that's back in 1711. We talk about climb milling versus conventional milling. But so we do want to climb mill. We want to start in this position over here. So we'll lead to rapid to the X positive. And, you know, if I was smart, I'd come in here and I'd make my positive values one number or one color. And my negative values should be a different color. So let's go green with positive and red for negative. Make sure I'm doing that right. Seems right so far. I'll have to check that because sometimes I don't think while I'm talking on the video, as you probably are aware. All right, so we'll go to positive X 1.25, and the y for that is negative 2.375. And we don't need a feed rate for that, but we'll put in a z value. Let's go into z 1.0. So we'll wrap it to that point in space. We have said that our stated assumption is that, well, let's just say our assumption is now, and we should state it somewhere, that our z 1.0 is a safe level to z around to wrap it around in. We'll need to change this, whatever the assignment says. All right, so don't get that from me. Get that from the assignment. All right, so we're wrapped to this position, and then we will feed down, and we'll need a feed rate. Well, let's just use 10 for this. We'll talk about calculating speeds and feeds later on. Oh, speaking of which, we will need a speed here. All right, so we've got a spindle speed. Let's run that to 1,000 RPM. We need to turn the spindle on. So let's do that out here outside of the header, because that is something that we do, well, in this class, sometimes we turn the spindle on, sometimes we don't. So I'll just, for our purposes, we'll stick it out there. All right, so spindle's on. We're feeding down feed rate. Now we need a G1 move that goes up in the Y to Y negative 1.375. And we're going to keep that same feed rate. That's okay. And it's this move. This is the move that exists for the sole purpose of turning on our cutter comp. Okay, so this is where we're going to put in either a G41 or a G42. So we have to think about this. If we're moving in this direction, do we want 41 or 42? Do we want compensation left, or do we want compensation right? Well, if we were driving that tool, we would have to steer to the left to avoid gouging the part. And so we want left compensation. And so we'll ask for a G. We'll put it back here. I don't know, offset a little bit from that G1, 41. And we need to put in the D number that matches our tool. Okay, let's see. So I don't know, that's a little bit messy, but it's okay. I think that's going to get the job done. So now in this move from this point to that point, our tool will be compensated for. If we're using a 0.75 diameter tool, when it starts, that tool would start in this position. And when it finishes, it should be right there. Okay, and as it goes around, it will go around the outside of that part. There you go. Maybe that helps. This should be the actual path that the cutter will take. All right. So you see it's going to come in here. It's going to start deviating from the program path. It's going to shift over as it goes in this first move. So it's important that this happens off of the part. All right. So that is the actual motion of the cutter around. You'll notice that we've got this lead in and lead out. So that's so that we go in and engage the material in a nice sort of gentle way, and then when we finish, we overlap by a little bit, and then we lead out to finish in a nice smooth motion. And there's that path without all the circles turned on, so you can see the path that the center point of the tool will take around. So maybe that's a little bit helpful. All right, but these are the points that we need to do the programming. We don't need to simulate what the cutter is going to do. So let's just keep it clean like this. All right, so we've just continued this point here. A lot of times it's a good idea, especially when you start to get a lot of points like this, is to go in and actually give these points some names. All right, so there we've got P1 through 10. All right, so, and what I want to do here is I'll label these as comments. So there we wrap it. Maybe that'll remind me what that is. And this is feed down. Very important. Keep in mind that it's very possible that your code will be running on the machine, actually cutting metal. So this code has to be right. So you do want to do a little bit of bookkeeping and make sure that it's all in good shape. There we go. So this is the move where we turn our compensation on, and it's also the move to P2. All right, and now we need to do an arc. Let's see. What arc program would make the most sense? Well, first of all, the direction. This is counterclockwise, so that's a GO3. So the GO3, what does it need? It needs the end point. So we have the x value of 0.25 in the positive, and a y value of 0.375 in the negative. And what else do we need? Well, if we already know the radius, so we can just put that in there. All right, so this is a radius of 1.0. And let's see, this is P3. All right, and then we need to shift back to G1. And there we go. I'll just do a G3 instead of GO3. Then let's see, to get to 0.4, we need to have an X move to negative 1.625. And from there, now we need to have another arc. And in this case, it is, what is that, clockwise. All right, so from there to there, that's clockwise, so that's a G2. And we need, what else do we need? X value is going to be the same. It's still that negative negative 1.625. We need a Y value. Now let's try to get those roughly lined up. We need a Y value, in this case positive 0.375, and we need let's see, that radius, we'll just do it that way. That radius is 0.375. And we need to go ahead, oops, I'm losing these. This is 0.5. This was supposed to be 0.4. All right, so that gets us here to 0.5. 0.6, we just move, well, we need to get back into G1 mode and go to x positive 1.625. Some nice symmetry happening there. Now, let's see, oh, that's 0.6. Dang it. All right. Now to get to, from 0.6 to 0.7, that is a clockwise move. So that's a G2. And the only thing we have is a shift in the Y. So now we have to go down Y negative 0.375. And we'll need a radius 0.375. And that's going to be the 0.7 command to get us to 0.7. And then 0.8. We'll shift back to G1. We need to get in our, let's see, X goes negative on us, negative 250. And what else do we need? Now we need to lead out. That looks like a G3, I believe. And it's going to need an X and a Y. So the X is negative 1.25. And the Y is negative 1.375. I'm losing track of my points. That's 0.9. This was 0.8. All right, then we need to shift back to G1, and we'll also turn the cutter comp off. We'll have to remember to do this in this move. So as we go from 9 to 10, this is the motion that's going to, where the tool is going to adjust back down so that its center point is on the commanded point. We're going to go, first the X is negative 1.25. I guess we didn't have to say that again because we're already there. So let's not. And the Y is negative 2.375. And we need to G40 that to shut the compensation off. This is P10, comp off. And then we'll just Z to we'll do a G1 and we'll Z up to a, let's shift this over here, Z1.0, tool up, we'll call it. There we go. All right, so I think that's right. I'll go out and drop this into NC Viewer. All right, and it looks like I've screwed up, so I've got a little bit of troubleshooting that I'll have to do. All right, a lot of this, let's see here. That was a mistake. I'll try that. And then I had this G3 down here. He's got the wrong radius in there. Try that. That's better. And let me try to figure out what's going on with this other bit over here. All right, I'm not sure what the issue is because I look at it and it seems mostly right. If I add a 10,000th out there, he seems to make this just fine, so I'm not sure if there's a rounding error or something going on out there. But generally, this thing is pretty good, and usually when there's a mistake, it's mine, so I'll just say I haven't found it yet. So adding that extra 10th out there does seem to fix it, so that tells me that maybe it's some kind of a rounding error or something like that. Or maybe I've made a mistake that I don't see yet. But anyway, now it's working pretty well. Let's see here. So where'd that go? There we go. All right, so that's kind of what we want to see. Of course, that'll bother me. I'll go try it on the Haas and see what kind of reaction I get out of the machine.